Good morning, dear students. How are you? I hope you all are fine and stay safe at home. During this lockdowns, we have brought some new techniques to learn at home. I'm Phool Kumari from Sri Vasishtha Vidyalaya.
Today, I'm going to teach social studies of standard 4th, 2nd chapter that focuses on Northern Plains. Let's learn about what are the things that we are going to learn in this lesson. The first is location of the Northern Plains, river basin in the Northern Plains, life in the region and importance of the Northern Plains. Let's move towards the Northern Plains. The Northern Plains lie between the Himalayas in the north and the Peninsular Plateau in the south. With the help of Indian political map, we can also see that Northern Plains occupy a great part of North India. It extends from Punjab in the west to Assam in the east. They covers the states of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal and some parts of Assam. Now, there are many rivers that flow in the Northern Plains. They are Ravi, Satluj, Yamuna, Ganga and Brahmaputra. They flow through the Northern Plains. These rivers also carry sand and silt with them, which get deposited in the plains that makes the soil very fertile, which is ideal for growing crops. Before moving ahead, I want to explain about the important terms which is there in this lesson. The first is basin. Let's learn what is basin. The area watered by a river and its tributaries is called basin. Remember, the area which is watered by a river and its tributaries is called basin. The second is tributaries. What is tributaries? A smaller stream that flows into a larger stream. That is what is tributary. Let's move ahead with the river basins in the Northern Plains. The Northern Plains can be divided into three river basins. The first is the Ganga basin in the center. The second is the Brahmaputra basin in the east. And the third is the Indus Basin in the west. Next we have the Ganga Basin. The Ganga River Basin. The Ganga River Basin covers an area of 861,404 square kilometers in the north. The river originates from the Gangotri Glacier at Gomukh in the Himalayas. It flows through Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Haryana, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal. The Ganga Basin is the most populated part in India and is a home of more than 500 million people, making it the most populated river basin in the world. Let's move towards the Brahmaputra River Basin. The river Brahmaputra starts from Tibet and flows parallel to the Himalayas in Tibet and enters India through Arunachal Pradesh. The Brahmaputra and the river Ganga form the largest delta in the world. It is called the Sundarban Delta. Here I want to tell you about delta. Delta is a triangular shaped land formed by the deposition of silt at the mouth of river. Again, you listen, children. Delta is a triangular shaped land formed by the deposition of silt at the mouth of a river. Next, we have the Indus River Basin. The River Indus and its five tributaries such as the Jhelum, the Chenab, the Ravi, the Bees and the Satluj form the vast fertile tract of the western part of the northern plains of India. Some of the important cities of the region are Chandigarh, Jalandhar, Patiala, Ludhiana, Ambala and Amritsar. Students, have you heard about Bhakra Nangal Dam? Let's see. The Bhakra Nangal Dam built across the river Satluj is famous for hydroelectricity production and irrigation facility. Now let's know about the life in the region. The basin has many religious cities like Rishikesh, Haridwar, Allahabad and Varanasi. A majority of population of this region is engaged in agricultural activities. Let us know about the popular festival celebrated here. That is Diwali, Eid, Durga Puja and Chhath Puja. Let's move towards the importance of the Northern Plains. The Northern Plains are the gift of the Himalaya rivers. The soil of this region is very fertile. The Northern Plains are also called the greenery of India because many important crops such as rice, millets, wheat, pulses, etc. are grown here. Next we have, this region has well developed agro-based industries such as jute and cotton textile, sugar, vegetable oil, dairy products and leather. The Northern Plains are thickly populated and well developed in terms of transport and communication. Now let's recapitulate the things that we have learned in this chapter. Now, the first thing that we have learned here is the Northern Plains occupy a large part of North India. Second, many rivers that flow through the Northern Plains making it fertile for agriculture. Third, the Northern Plains have three river basins, that is the Ganga River Basin, the Brahmaputra River Basin and the Indus River Basin. The Ganga-Brahmaputra Delta is the largest delta in the world. Now students, it's time for an activity. So here I have brought one interesting activity to collect information about the states covering the northern plains and the rivers forming the tributary plains. You can also take the help of an internet to collect information. So it was a brief introduction to understand the concept of Northern Plains. Have a good day ahead. Thank you.